اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون ما يأتيهم من ذكر من ربهم محدث إلا استمعوه وهم يلعبون لاهية قلوبهم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My beloved brothers, sisters and viewers Welcome to today's episode Today we're going to be speaking or taking lessons from the 17th juz of the Qur'an That starts with Surah Al-Anbiya The Surah of the Prophets And it is mentioned that it is the surah of the remembrance that has been revealed to our beloved prophets alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And the word remembrance, dhikr, or the word derivatives has been mentioned 10 times in this surah, subhanallah. The surah started off with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about the day of resurrection and giving us warnings from being, subhanallah, neglecting the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ مَا يَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ مُحْدَثٍ إِلَّا اسْتَمَعُوهُ وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ لاهية قلوبهم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the meaning of this ayah or these two ayahs that I've recited that the people's day of hisab of questioning and the day of resurrection has come close and they are what? وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ and they are just subhanallah neglecting it and not even thinking about it وَمَا يَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ there is no remembrance or verse or sign or messenger or revelation that has been sent to them except that they are what? إِلَّا اسْتَمَعُوهُ They will hear it and they will be continue to play as if they heard nothing. لَا هِيَةً قُلُوبُهُمْ Their hearts have no care, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's just lost in these worldly things. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, Ya رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again in this surah speaks about emphasizes on the matter of tawheed in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the proof of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through intellect and also through physical things that we can see in this universe. And Allah Azza wa Jalla also mentions about the day of resurrection also or Yawm al-Qiyamah. In this surah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions Ibrahim alayhi salam and how he broke all the idols that his people including his father used to worship. And subhanAllah it shows the strength of tawakkul of relying that Ibrahim alayhi salam used to have the tawakkul upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam used to have. And Allah Azza wa Jalla after this mentions a number of the stories of the prophets alayhim salam and how that the people that rejected them, rejected these prophets, how Allah Azza wa Jalla punished them and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to those that followed those prophets. In this surah, subhanAllah, there are a number of stories of the prophets and how Allah Azza wa Jal put them in their hardship or tested them with them being or going through hardship and how with them returning to Allah Azza wa Jal and asking Allah alone for dua, Allah Azza wa Jal saved them from so much difficulty, subhanAllah. And this is a very strong link that was between the prophets and of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that any hardship they would go through, they will return straight and directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah azza wa jal for help and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for support. And in result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them from their people and subhanallah put punishment upon the people that rejected them and fought them. Subhanallah, examples of these stories is Ayyub alayhi salam, for example, when he was ill and he only complained, he was patient. There is a story for us from the patient of Ayyub alayhi salam and how much patience he had when he was ill, but he only complained and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah azza wa jalla in result cured him. And subhanallah also the story of Yunus alayhi salam and how he was in the stomach of the whale And while he was there, subhanAllah, he was remembering the shortcomings he had, and he said, and he made dua and said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minal zalimeen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. And in this, my beloved brothers and sisters, we take lessons, subhanAllah. And I would like to mention this, is that take lessons from the dua that is mentioned in the Qur'an. The dua that the prophets used to make. Take these du'as and try and make these du'as in your life, and they are the best of du'as that you can make, inshallah ta'ala, du'a of the Qur'an and the du'a of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At the end of this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of the destiny of the mushrikeen, those that associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the, what will be happening to their idols that they used to worship. And in the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the tawheed and how that seeking or taking the path of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the success that one will find bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal in this dunya and in the akhirah by gaining bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal the highest levels of Jannah. We ask Allah to make us from the people of Jannah and the people of the highest levels of Jannah. Allahumma ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks next about the great surah, Suratul Hajj, which is the second or the next part of this juz. And Suratul Hajj, subhanAllah, speaks a lot about the matter of what they call chastity, or what is known as modesty and purity, subhanAllah. And how the Islam takes a lot of care about this topic, the purity and modesty of the Muslim men and women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts off the surah with a scary speech that shows, subhanAllah, how the situation would be or how it is on the Day of Judgment, subhanAllah, but a similar comparison to what it is like on the Day of Judgment, but on this earth, and that is Al-Hajj, which is something that is a should be a reminder for the believers of the Day of Resurrection, of how people, subhanAllah, all could come together, subhanAllah, when we are resurrected. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be of those that will enter Jannah with no punishment or questioning. Allahumma ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also warns us, my beloved brothers and sisters, again of our first enemy, the first enemy to the humankind, and that is Shaytan, which was an enemy to our father Adam alayhi salam and Hawa. And also Allah azza wa jalla warns us from following the mushrikeen and those that argue and debate and be stubborn and reject the idea of resurrection with no knowledge and no guidance, subhanAllah. So be aware of both these things, the following of these type of people and also the following of the shaytan, and be very careful from the plotting and trickery of the shaytan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers these people, subhanAllah, in a verse that he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, uses the creation or the beginning of the creation of the human being, subhanAllah, as a proof of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also the example of Allah Azza wa Jal bringing a village or land that has been removed or demolished, bringing it back to life, subhanAllah, as an example for those that reject that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that can create this human being and subhanAllah, this human going through all of these different stages of life, subhanAllah, as well as this land that has been brought back to life, as a proof that Allah Azza wa Jal, the one that can do this, it is easier and as easy for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to resurrect us on the Day of Judgment, subhanAllah. And this is an answer for those people that reject this. And if one looks in the universe and looks at the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a heart that is looking for truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them bi-idhnillahi ta'ala to the haqq, to the religion, inshaAllah, of Islam. And subhanAllah, the core of this surah and what this surah has been named after is the Hajj, which in this surah also Allah Azza wa Jal mentions this and mentions the way or the performing of Hajj through Ibrahim alayhi salam. And subhanAllah, as we mentioned before in Surah Al-Baqarah took care or mentioned the Hajj or the part of Hajj that has to do with the physical way of doing Hajj. However, in this surah, it is focusing on the heart and solely part of ibadah, of this fariḍa, fardul hajj. SubhanAllah, as Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in some of the verses, وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ, and also, وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ, and so on and so forth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks next about those that have been given the power by Allah Azza wa Jal to rule in the lands on the earth that has been created and that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They must rule it by what Allah Azza wa Jal has ordered us to rule it with, subhanAllah. And this is in the verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
الَّذِينَ إِن مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَهَوْا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرُ وَلِلَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ.
They are those that what if Allah Azza wa Jal gave them power in the land, what do they do? They establish prayer, they give zakah, purifying their wealth through giving zakah, and they enjoin good and forbid evil. This is what, inshaAllah, we should be asking Allah Azza wa Jal and working towards bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal then speaks about some of the people that rejected their prophets. And after that, Allah Jalla fi ulah speaks again about the plotting of the shaitan and the fitna the shaitan will make Bani Adam, will make us, the human being, subhanAllah, fall into, or try and make you fall into. So be careful, my beloved brother and sister, and return to Allah Azza wa Jal, and know that you will not be able with your own strength to avoid falling in the plotting and trickery of the shaitan, but you will be able to when you return and you ask and seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from shaitan and the plotting and trickery of shaitan bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And in the last parts of Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the proofs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being able to resurrect us, and on the Day of Judgment, all the human beings, subhanAllah, being resurrected, subhanAllah, and also rejects all what the people that claim the partnership with Allah Azza wa Jal, rejects everything that they say and claim, with the proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to resurrect them. And they that did not believe in the resurrection and that there is a next life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them of the proof of that in this surah also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in the last part of the surah about al-jihadu fi sabilillah, to strive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rule by the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stick firmly with the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to keep us all firm. My beloved brothers and sisters, I ask Allah to accept from us and from you all in these blessed days. Please remember me in your dua, and I will do the same, inshaAllah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.